Recorded Books and RB Digital present Charlie and Mouse by Laurel Snyder. Illustrated by Emily Hughes. Read by Christopher Carley. Lumps. Charlie woke up. There was a lump beside him. He poked the lump. The lump moaned.
"Are you awake?"
Charlie asked.
"No," said the lump. "I am sleeping."
"How can you be sleeping?" asked Charlie.
"You are talking."
The lump stopped talking. Charlie poked the lump again.
"Get up,"
he said to the lump. The lump did not get up.
"Get up,"
Charlie said to the lump.
"Today is the neighborhood party."
"It is?" asked the lump.
"Yes, it is," said Charlie.
The lump turned into Mouse. Mouse ran down the hall.
"Mom,"
said Mouse.
"Dad."
He opened a door. He found two lumps. Mouse poked one of the lumps.
"Are you awake?"
"No,"
said the lump.
"We are sleeping."
"How can you be sleeping?"
asked Mouse.
"You are talking."
"I am a mom,"
said the lump.
"I can do what I want."
The party.
"Hurrah! Today is the party,"
shouted Charlie.
"Today is the neighborhood party,"
shouted Mouse.
"Everyone will be there,"
shouted Charlie. They danced around the kitchen. "Where is the party going to be?" asked Dad.
"It is at the playground,"
said Charlie.
"When is it going to be?"
asked Mom.
"Now,"
said Charlie. "Sounds fun," said Dad. "I'll bring cookies." The four of them set out. They pulled Blanket in the wagon. They brought cookies. Halfway down the street, Charlie and Mouse saw Helen and Lily and Sam. Helen and Lily were climbing a tree. Sam was watching.
"Where are you going?"
asked Lily.
"Today is the neighborhood party,"
shouted Mouse.
"Come on."
Helen and Lily and Sam followed the wagon. A few houses down, Charlie and Mouse saw Jack and Max. Jack and Max were digging a hole.
"Where are you going?"
asked Jack.
"Today is the neighborhood party,"
shouted Charlie.
"Come on."
Jack and Max followed Helen and Lily and Sam, who followed the wagon. When they turned onto Woodland Avenue, Charlie and Mouse saw Tess and Lottie. Tess and Lottie were playing on the porch.
"Where are you going?"
asked Tess.
"Today is the neighborhood party," shouted everyone. "Come on."
Tess and Lottie followed Jack and Max, who followed Helen and Lily and Sam, who followed the wagon. Charlie and Mouse passed Spencer's house. They passed Marley's house. They passed Nora Ann's house. Baby Sylvia rode in the wagon with Blanket. Soon they could all see the playground.
"Hurrah!"
shouted Charlie.
"Soon we will be at the party."
They got to the playground. The playground was empty. Nobody was there.
It was the best party ever.
Rocks. "I wish I had some money," said Charlie.
"Yes," said Mouse. "I wish I had some money, too."
"How can we get some money?" asked Charlie.
"That is a good question,"
said Mouse.
"Let me think."
Mouse thought.
"I know,"
said Mouse.
"We will sell something."
"That is a good idea," said Charlie.
"But what will we sell?"
"Let me think again,"
said Mouse. Mouse thought.
"I know,"
said Mouse.
"We have lots of rocks. We will sell rocks."
"That is a good idea," said Charlie. "You are very smart, Mouse."
"Thank you,"
said Mouse. Charlie and Mouse loaded the wagon with their very best rocks. They pulled the wagon down the street. They pulled it to Mr. Eric and Mr. Michael's house. They knocked on the door.
"Do you need any rocks today?" asked Mouse.
"No," said Mr. Eric. "We have too many rocks already,
but if you will take ours away, I will give you a dollar.
Okay,
said Charlie.
Okay,
said Mouse. Charlie and Mouse took away Mr. Eric's rocks. Charlie and Mouse pulled their wagon to Miss Margaret's house. They knocked on her door.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.